There are bizarre planets in the universe, from planets that complete an orbit around their star in a few hours to other planets with dusty tails like comets. But could there be a planet made entirely of water? What does science say about it? Would the laws of physics allow a planet without a core and only water to form? Let's find out. Without further ado, these are some of the exoplanets that could be made entirely of water. Kepler-62e and Kepler-62f. These two planets, which orbit the star Kepler-62, are fascinating because they are in their star's habitable zone, which means they could have liquid water on their surfaces. Kepler-62e is the closest planet to the star and is similar in size to Earth, but its surface temperature is about 0 degrees Celsius. This makes it very cold compared to Earth, but still within a range in which liquid water could exist. Kepler-62f, on the other hand, is a bit colder, with a surface temperature of about minus 40 degrees Celsius. What makes Kepler-62e and Kepler-62f even more interesting is that their sizes and masses are similar to Earth's, suggesting that they might have a similar internal structure and possibly a life-supporting atmosphere. However, it is essential to note whether these planets have liquid water on their surfaces has not yet been confirmed. Also, Kepler-62 is exciting because it is a dwarf star similar to the Sun, which means it has a much longer lifetime than the most prominent and brightest stars. This means Kepler-62 and its planets can exist for billions of years, giving them ample time to develop and evolve. It is important to note that searching for habitable planets is a very active field in astronomy. More and more exoplanets that could have liquid water on their surface are being discovered, which means there may be many more habitable planets out there waiting to be discovered. Kepler-62e and Kepler-62f are fascinating planets that could harbor liquid water on their surfaces and possibly life. As exoplanet detection technology and methods continue to improve, we may find more planets like these, allowing us to explore and learn more about the possibility of life elsewhere in the universe. In addition to their potentially habitable features, Kepler-62e and Kepler-62f also hold some exciting mysteries and curiosities. For example, these planets are believed to have very long days. Because they are so close to their star, they are gravitationally locked, which means they always show the same face to their star. This means that one side of the planet is always in light and the other is always in the dark. Regarding their composition, both exoplanets are believed to have a mixture of rock and water. Some scientists believe these planets could be covered in a layer of water up to 500 kilometers thick. Can you imagine that? An ocean 500 kilometers deep? Just to give you an idea, on Earth, the deepest part of the ocean is the Challenger Deep, which is only 11 kilometers deep. It's nothing in comparison. This theory that these exoplanets have such a thick layer of water is based on the measurement of their density, since water is the only compound that meets the chemical property that has been measured on these two planets. TRAPPIST-1e and TRAPPIST-1f. TRAPPIST-1 is a star system located 39 light-years from Earth, consisting of an ultra-cool dwarf star and 7 planets, 3 of which are in the system's habitable zone. Among these planets are TRAPPIST-1e and TRAPPIST-1f, highlighted as promising candidates for the search for life. TRAPPIST-1e is the 4th planet in order of distance from its star and is about the same size as Earth. It is in the system's habitable zone, which means that its surface temperature could allow the existence of liquid water on its surface. However, due to the proximity of its star, it is believed that TRAPPIST-1e could be gravitationally anchored, meaning that one side of the planet always points to its star. This could make the planet's surface extremely inhospitable, with temperatures ranging from minus 40 degrees Celsius to 106 degrees Celsius. On the other hand, TRAPPIST-1f is the 5th planet in order of distance from its star and is also in the system's habitable zone. It is slightly larger than Earth and is believed to have a thick atmosphere made mostly of hydrogen gas. Despite being in the habitable zone, TRAPPIST-1f is thought to receive 30% less light from its star than Earth does from the Sun, meaning it could be too cold for life as we know it. One of the most exciting aspects of TRAPPIST-1e and TRAPPIST-1f is that they are in a highly compact planetary system. The planets are so close to each other that if someone were on the surface of one of the planets, they could see the other planets as bright nearby worlds. Also, due to the planet's proximity, tidal currents may stir up atmospheres of the planets, which could affect habitability. The search for life in TRAPPIST-1e and TRAPPIST-1f is an essential topic in astrobiology. The presence of liquid water on a planet's surface is believed to be one of the critical requirements for life as we know it, and TRAPPIST-1e and TRAPPIST-1f are two of the best candidates for the existence of liquid water. Scientists are working on new telescope technologies to study these atmospheres and determine if there are signs of life on these planets. HD 219134b. HD 219134b is a Neptune-sized exoplanet orbiting a nearby star called HD 219134, only 21 light-years from Earth. It was discovered in 2015 by the Kepler Space Telescope and has been the subject of interest to astronomers ever since, due to its potential to host water and other compounds essential to life. One of the most exciting features of HD 219134b is its proximity to Earth. Compared to many other exoplanets, this one is relatively close to our solar system, making it an attractive space exploration and research target. Its closeness also means astronomers can study its features and composition better. Another exciting aspect of HD 219134b is its orbit. The exoplanet completes one orbit around its star in just 3 Earth days, meaning its year lasts just 3 days. Due to this close orbit, the exoplanet is believed to have an extremely high surface temperature, which could exceed 700 degrees Celsius. Despite this extreme temperature, it is believed that HD 219134b could have a thick atmosphere that could harbor liquid water. Astronomers have used spectroscopy to study the atmosphere of HD 219134b. This technique analyzes the light that passes through the exoplanet's atmosphere as it orbits its star. The data collected suggests that the exoplanet's atmosphere is composed primarily of hydrogen and helium, with trace amounts of water vapor and carbon dioxide. These results have led astronomers to speculate that HD 219134b could have an atmosphere similar to Neptune's, with an upper layer of hydrogen and helium and a lower layer rich in water and other compounds. But perhaps the most critical piece of information about HD 219134b is its potential to host life on its moons. Even though the exoplanet's surface is highly inhospitable due to its temperature, it is possible that some of its moons could have more favorable conditions. Some theories suggest that the moons of exoplanets like HD 219134b could be more habitable than the planets. GJ 1214c. GJ 1214c is a super-Earth-type exoplanet that orbits the red dwarf GJ1214, located in the constellation Ophiuchus, about 40 light-years from Earth. It was discovered in 2009 by the Hubble Space Telescope. It is considered one of the most exciting exoplanets for the search for life due to the presence of a dense atmosphere and the possibility of having water on its surface. The exoplanet has a mass of about 6.5 times that of Earth, and its radius is about 2.7 times that of Earth. Due to its size and density, it is believed that GJ1214c may be composed of a rocky core and an atmosphere rich in water and volatile gases such as hydrogen and helium. Its average surface temperature is estimated to be around 232 degrees Celsius, making it too hot to support life as we know it. Although GJ1214c is believed to be an exoplanet made entirely of water, it is unknown due to a lack of information about its internal structure. However, some studies suggest it could have a global ocean with a depth of up to 200 kilometers. In addition, the exoplanet's dense atmosphere could shield its surface from ultraviolet radiation and water evaporation. The dense atmosphere of this exoplanet has also been studied due to the presence of water vapor in it. The Hubble Space Telescope has detected light absorption in its atmosphere, indicating the presence of water vapor. Furthermore, the spectrum of light passing through its atmosphere also suggests the presence of other molecules, such as methane and carbon dioxide. The study of the atmosphere of GJ1214c has led scientists to question the possibility that this exoplanet could harbor life. Although the exoplanet's surface is too hot to support life as we know it, some studies suggest that there could be life forms that can adapt to the extreme conditions of its atmosphere and oceans. Of all the planets mentioned so far, this is the closest to being entirely made of water. But as we can see, it is still not known for sure what its composition is. So we must ask ourselves, is it physically possible that a planet made entirely of water exists? The answer is yes, and that planet exists, and it's called Gliese 1214b. Gliese 1214b. Gliese 1214b is an exoplanet discovered in 2009 by the Hubble Space Telescope. This planet is located approximately 40 light years away in the constellation Ophiuchus. One of the most exciting features of Gliese 1214b is that it is believed to be a planet made entirely of water. This planet orbits very close to its star, only 1.5 million kilometers away, so it completes one orbit in just 1.5 Earth days. Due to its proximity to the star, the planet is constantly exposed to high temperatures. Despite this, the pressure on the planet's surface is so high that the water is believed to be in an exotic state known as superionic water. Superionic water is a state of matter found in extreme temperature and pressure conditions. In this state, the hydrogen in the water ionizes and becomes an electrical conductor, while the oxygen remains in a liquid state. This makes superionic water an excellent conductor of electricity and an extraordinary material. The discovery of Gliese 1214b has led to many questions and speculation about the possibility of life on water planets. Although this planet is not habitable due to its proximity to its star and extremely high temperatures, its discovery has led to the theory that there may be other similar planets in other star systems that are habitable. Another interesting fact about Gliese 1214b is that water vapor has been found in its atmosphere. This discovery has led to the idea that other similar planets may have water-rich atmospheres, which could be a sign of the existence of life. Furthermore, studying this planet's atmosphere has led to a better understanding of how planetary atmospheres interact with their stars. This planet is believed to have formed from ice and dust that accumulated around its star during the formation of the planetary system. As the planet formed and moved closer to its star, the heat from the star melted the ice, turning it into water. This formation process is essential because water planets are considered standard in the galaxy and may be an important life form. Water is believed to be a key component to life as we know it, and water planets may be one way life can exist elsewhere in the universe. Each of the exoplanets mentioned above has unique characteristics, from the potential to support life to the possibility that they are made entirely of water. These discoveries are a sample of the potential that exists in the exploration of space in the universe. The search for exoplanets and the exploration of the universe push us forward and inspire us to continue investigating and discovering. This task may seem daunting, but each discovery, technological advance, and each new theory brings us one step closer to understanding the universe and our place in it.